We're going to find a volume of rotation in this problem. Let's draw a picture first. If you remember what the sine of x looks like, 2 pi is over here and 3 pi is over here. So we're going to rotate this region right here about the y-axis. And if you'll recall, we could do this a couple different ways. There's a washer method and there's a shell method. If we use the washer method, we would have to split up our region just like this. And we would have to then rotate this region about the y-axis. But hopefully you'll notice this is probably not the easiest way to do this, because the length of this little slice of this region here, or in other words, the outer and inner radius of this region, are both defined by this y equals sine of x function. And since the thickness of this little slice is dy, we would actually need to integrate with respect to y, and getting this function in terms of y is going to give us a pretty ugly looking problem. So I very much hope that this is not going to be the most convenient way to do this. Instead, what I'm going to suggest is slicing up this little region vertically. The height of this slice is then given by the function y equals sine of x, but the thickness of this slice is dx. So I think that our variables and our integral are going to work out a little bit more nicely if we use the shell method. Let's try it out. We're going to integrate with respect to x. We're going to be integrating from 2 pi to 3 pi. The radius of each one of these cylindrical shells that we create by rotating this region around the y-axis is going to be this distance right here. It's simply going to be the x value, and that x value can range anywhere from 2 pi to 3 pi, just like our limits of integration say. So long story short, our radius is just x. The height of each one of these cylindrical shells is just given by the function sine of x. So this turns out pretty nicely. This is actually an integration by parts integral, and we've done something like this before. We can choose u equals x, and we can choose dv equals sine of x. Integrating to get v gives us negative cosine of x. All right, we can now use our integration by parts formula to rewrite this integral. Uv is negative x cosine of x minus the integral of v du minus a negative simplifies to a plus, and the integral of cosine x is positive sine x. And I was just about to put a plus c on that when I realized that we actually do have limits of integration. We integrated from 2 pi to 3 pi. So let's plug in those upper and lower limits of integration. And cosine of 3 pi is going to be the same thing as the cosine of pi, which is negative 1. The sine of 3 pi is going to be 0. Cosine of 2 pi is going to be positive 1. And the sine of 2 pi, again, is going to be 0. So what does that leave us with? That's going to leave us with a positive 3 pi from the first term and a plus 2 pi from the third term. Hey, and that's pretty cool. It looks like our answer turns out to be 5 pi. But this is a volume, so I guess that would be in some kind of units cubed. But I'll zoom out on this thing so you can take a look at the whole process. Well, that was pretty fun. I hope that helps you out.